Welcome to Python with Andrew, where we look at various bits of Python in short videos, and then you get a chance to practice. In this one, we're going to carry on talking about functions. And in this case, we're going to, if you like, make it a bit more general and use functions to make our code a bit more general. So let's see what I mean by that. Let's go over to our code and look at our work. If you look at what we had previously, we defined a function with the def, the function name, open, close bracket, and colon. And then this particular function, very, very simple. It just prints hello, everyone. That's the definition of the function. We then need to call the function. And we can call it wherever we like in our program. In this case, that's all my program does, just to keep it nice and simple. And of course, if I save that and run that, it does exactly what we want. Hello, everyone. But let's make it a bit more general, because instead of saying hello, everyone, I want to define a function that says hello and the person's name. So I'm going to put in here the name, all right? So that is a variable. That is called a parameter to the function, all right? I can have one, or I could do 10, or I can do as many as I like, and we can do further of that. And in this case, all I'm going to do is I'm going to use that parameter and put it here, okay? So my definition of the function, a little bit more complex. It's more general, because now I can use this to do an introduction to Andrew, to Peter, to Martha, to Jill, to anyone I like. And in this particular case, I've defined that function with one parameter. It's not returning anything, it's not doing anything complex, one parameter, and it's using that parameter. Okay, now when I call it, I need to give it an argument. In this case, we're going to go, hello, Andrew. Okay, and let me put a capital A for Andrew. And we can see my code there. And if I now run it, instead of saying hello, everyone, it says hello, Andrew. Okay. And if I do another one, it's hello, Peter. Okay. And if I run that again, I've got hello, Andrew, hello, Peter. So that's what we say by making the function more general. Because instead of writing two functions, one that says hello, Andrew, another one that says hello, Peter, I've got one, and I can now use it for any name I like. Right? So it's what we call a more general idea, and it's part of what we call in programming abstraction. An abstraction is when you create some code that can be used in a more general fashion, and if you like, handle more cases. So instead of writing two functions here, I've written one that I can use twice, three times, 50 times, whatever I like. Okay, so that's a nice, easy function there. Now, I can create another function that takes two arguments, right? And this one I'm going to call multiply. I'll call it multi. And I'm going to create x, y. And guess what this is going to do? It's going to go x times y, right? Answer equals x times y, okay? Now, I can call this later on, multi 10 times 5. Actually, I don't want to call it, I want to just print out. Print. X times Y, okay. I can call that multi, I'm getting rid of my calls to into. So I'll create another function, multi, takes two parameters this time, X and Y. So those names I can call whatever I like. And all it's gonna do is multiply X and Y, okay. And I can call that multi 10 times five. And of course, if I clear this, it gives us exactly what we'd expect, the answer 50. I can call that again, multi 10 times 15. And it's a bit better, you know, it gives me 150. I can even call this a bit more complex. This is where we start multi 10 plus 12 comma 15. All right. So in this case, instead of a simple argument of an integer, I have done a bit more complex argument of 10 plus 12. Okay. So if I do that, it does the 10 plus 12 first and gives me 22. And then it does the calling of the function. So this would be the equivalent, same as doing multi 22 comma 15. Okay. It does the calculation first and then passes that into the function called multi. And in my case, it's just printing it out. There's nothing fancy of that. So very simple concepts here. First of all, one is that we must remember that we can have parameters here. You can see it already says parameter. We call it with an argument, right? We can have one, or in this case, we've got two. We could have three, four. We could have as many as we like. We can even have an undetermined number, which we'll see later on. So we can call this, and it does the work. We can also call it, and it evaluates the arguments first, then calls the function. And that's going to be something we explore a lot as we go forward. Okay, so again, simple definitions. I haven't created a complex function. It's only one line, nothing fancy at this point. So do experiment. You can see because I've defined two and I've only called one, that's the only one that's going to work. Remember, it's not going to do the hello name because I'm not calling, I'm not using it, right? And that's also going to be very, very important later on because we're going to define a function, test to make sure it works, and then we're going to put it aside while we define another function, check it if it works, etc. And only at the end, we'll put it all together. And that's a useful part of programming, sort of doing it bit by bit by bit, breaking up a big problem into small problems, write a function, two functions, three functions, then at the end, put it all together. Okay, so that's a short, sharp part on functions with one or more parameters. In a little while, we'll talk about what happens when you want to return a value from a function. What does that look like? Thanks again for watching. Do share these with your friends or subscribe if you're interested. Thanks. Have a great day.